What's up, YouTube? Today, I'm simply going to do an oil change. The car I'm going to be using is my personal car. So I'll show you what I do, the tools that I use, and some tips and techniques that I've learned changing my own oil. Alright, so let's show you what exactly you're going to need. Now, since I lowered my car, I'm going to want to use a scissor jack just to get it off the ground. And then I'm going to use the regular floor jack to raise the car high enough where I can place these two jack stands at the jack points. Some tools you will need are the appropriate size socket wrench to remove the drain bolt, a filter wrench to remove the filter, a drain bucket or some sort to drain the oil into, a set of rags to clean up, the recommended oil and oil filter, and you're going to want to find this type of information in your owner's manual, a funnel to drain, to use to facilitate the oil flow going into the engine, and something to lie underneath. Sometimes people have a creeper, but I just use a regular old exercise mat. So yeah, let's get our car jacked up. So, now that the car is in the air, I'm going to show you my typical jack setup. I have two jack stands at the jack points. You'll want to look in your owner's manual to find out where exactly yours are. Typically, they're on the frame of the car. And I have an extra jack just for safety. I just placed it underneath the tow hook because I know that it can handle the load. And you'll want to make sure that your handbrake is engaged prior to lifting to make sure that your rear wheels don't slip or move. Alright, so let's crawl underneath the car and
so get started. This is the drain bolt. It is right next to the driver's side axle on a D-series engine, right next to the exhaust piping, right directly underneath the engine block. If you can't find it, look in your owner's manual. And here is the oil filter. I've put the oil filter wrench already on it. As you can see, it's right underneath the driver's side axle, and yeah, it's actually black, so it's kind of hard to see underneath, but there you have it. I'm going to place the camera so you can see me struggle a little bit, and yeah, let's take these pieces off. All right, see you guys later. Alright, now that I've drained the old oil and I've removed the old oil filter, you're going to want to check on the mounting surface up top here if the old gasket still is there, and you're going to want to make sure that the old oil filter still has its gasket on it, because you don't want a double gasket when you put on the new filter. So right now I'm just going to lubricate the new oil filter with some oil on the seal itself, and yeah, I'm going to apply it on, and I'll show you how that goes. Hello. Alright, so now that the new oil filter is in, the old oil has been drained, we're going to lower the car, make sure that everything's put back in order, and then we're going to add fresh oil, and I'll show you how that goes. Oh, hi there. Now that the car is lowered and there's no oil in the engine, we're going to proceed to add fresh oil. Now, for all intents and purposes, today I'm going to be using a 5W-30. It says so on my oil cap, and it says so in the owner's manual. You're going to want to check your owner's manual to make sure that you're using the right oil as well. Alright, let's get started. Yeah, your oil cap might need some help to come off. And in the process, I've dented my oil cap. That's okay. Like there's some kind of moisture. You're gonna want to make sure your funnel is absolutely clean. Now, typical rule of thumb I like to use is for a 1.6 four-cylinder. It says in your owner's manual that you're gonna need 3.8 quarts, but just a general rule of thumb, I'll start off with 3.5, then I'll check my dipstick, then I'll add from there. Looks okay on the dipstick. I'm going to reapply the oil cap, and then I'm gonna start the car and let it cycle, and then I'm gonna check it again. So that's pretty much it, and you're gonna want to make sure that the oil level is where it's supposed to be, checking on the dipstick. But yeah, now we have fresh oil in the engine block and we're safe to start. Alright, so we started the car, and it's idling pretty smooth. It's at 211,224 miles. And yeah, let's check the oil again. Could use a little bit more. perfect. I don't know if you can see it in the camera, but yeah, it's right where it's supposed to be. The owner's manual says to put it in the middle of these two dots, but I usually fill up just right below the top dot. All right. And I think we're done. I'm just going to wrap up here. Make sure it's tight. Make sure there are no oil leaks. And then later on, you're gonna wanna let the car idle and check underneath for leaks. But other than that, we are good to go. See you guys later.